Green 6.
This is the Audiovisual Speech Processing Lab. We study audiovisual speech perception.
White 3.
We're interested in how children use visual cues to help understand speech and noise. There's a lot of different cues that they can use, so you might use visual cues to tell you when to listen. So seeing that I'm talking cues you that now's the time to pay attention. It can help to follow the rhythm of speech, or we sort of learn over time which face shapes and mouth movements go along with different speech sounds. So when those sounds are covered up by noise, you can fill in the blanks sort of with the visual information. Children spend a lot of time in noisy environments, and they're not as good as adults at listening to auditory speech in those environments. And so visual cues could be one of the best ways that they can compensate for not being terribly good at that. And so we're interested in sort of outlining when kids are able to use those cues, how soon they're able to use them as well as adults can, and sort of why some kids are better than others at using those cues. So we test children between 5 and 15 years of age, and then we also have adults for comparison. We bring them into the lab and set them inside of our sound booth, and they basically listen to some speech, usually in two different conditions, so just listening versus also seeing a video of the person talking. And then we compare how much better they do when they can see these videos. Sometimes we manipulate the stimuli to take out certain cues to see whether or not they were important, or look at the types of errors that they make and compare them to the types of errors that adults make.
Lock the cat in a shoe.
So after this project, the goal is to switch to testing children with hearing loss. We have some preliminary data to show that they're actually better than kids with normal hearing at using those visual speech cues, and we'd like to better understand why that's the case, whether they're simply paying attention more to what's on the face, whether they're better at combining the information they get from the auditory signal with what they get from the visual signal. In the long term, this research should help change the way that we assess and treat children with hearing loss. And we're really happy to be doing this work here at Boys Town.